I am Gail Locke McDowell, author of Crack and Coding Interview. Today we're going to talk about a topic that a lot of candidates forget about, heaps. Heaps come in one of two forms, a min heap or a max heap. We'll just focus on min heaps today, because a max heap is essentially the reverse. In a min heap, the elements are all smaller than their children. So the root node will be the very smallest element, and then looking down the tree, down the heap, the elements get bigger and bigger and bigger. So that's the basics of what a heap is, but how do we actually create and maintain such a data structure? So let's start with just insertion. So when we insert an element, it always goes in the next empty spot, looking top to bottom, left to right. So we go, first we insert an element here, and then here, and then here, and then here, and so on through the tree, through the heap. So that's how insertion works, but then, of course, what happens if that's not really where the element should go? Well, what we can do is we can insert the element there and then bubble it up until we get to the right spot. So we take the inserted element, we compare it with its parent. If it's out of order, swap them, and then keep going up the tree in this process. Now, what about removing the minimum element? So we know the minimum element will always be at the root node. And so that's easy to find, but then if we want to remove it, we might have an empty spot. So what we do here is we remove the min element there, so we take out the root, and then we swap that value at the root with the last element added. And then, of course, that element might not be at the right spot, so we take the root element and bubble it down to the next spot. So we compare the root with its children, its left child and its right child, and then swap it with the smaller of the two. And then we keep going down the tree until the heap property is restored. So that's how a tree operates. Let's think about how a heap operates. Let's talk about implementation now. So implementation is kind of interesting. You might have assumed that we'd implement it as a simple class node with a left node and a right node. And certainly we could do it that way. There's an even better way of implementing it. Note that when we add elements to the heap, they're always getting added in a very particular spot. There aren't going to be any gaps in the heap. So we have the zeroth element here, and then the first, second, third, fourth, etc. And so that means that we can actually use an array instead to store these values, and that makes it very compact. And a simple equation can map from an index to its left child, its right child, or to its parent. And so we can still get to the left and right child, but we don't need to have this overhead of a node class. So now that we've covered the basics of what a heap is, let's turn to the actual code for this. We'll implement a min heap with a simple class that wraps this items array. This is going to be an array of a fixed length, but if it gets too big, it will increase the capacity. Now I'm going to get a little bit of a head start and cheat a little bit by just adding in a whole bunch of simple helper methods. So these are just simple methods that get the left and right child or the parent index, actually, you know, check if they exist, or actually get the values themselves. So I'm just getting a little bit of a head start here. And I'll get another little bit of a head start by adding in two extra methods here. One is a swap method that swaps the values at two indices. And another one is an ensure extra capacity method. Now what this does is it checks if the array is full, and if so, it creates a new array of double that size and it copies all the elements over. And this, by the way, is the basics of how an array list operates. Now let's turn to the real code. The first method I'll implement is a peek method. And this, first it checks if the array is empty. If so, returns an exception because there's nothing at the front. Otherwise, it just returns the first element in the array, which will always be the minimum element and essentially the root of the heap. This method we'll do is a poll method. Now what this does is actually extract the minimum element and actually removes it from the array. So first we'll check if the array is empty. If so, throw an exception. Otherwise, I need to actually get the value. So item is items of zero. Then I need to take the very last element in the array and move it into the very first element. Then I need to shrink my array, or shrink essentially the size of it. And then I need to go and actually reheapify. So So I removed the root element, so I need to heapify down. And I'll go fill this method in shortly. So in this case, if we remove the 10, the minimum element, it's gonna get deleted. Then the 17 is gonna get moved up to where the 10 is. So see in the array, that's like this. So the 17 gets put in here. And then we go and adjust the heap to shift elements down as needed. My next method is going to actually add an element in here. So first thing I wanna do is I wanna make sure there is capacity. So I'll call my ensure extra capacity method. Then I'm gonna add my element into the very last spot. So items of size equals this new item. Then increase my size. And then I need to actually heapify up. So I need to fix the heap looking upwards, swapping each element with its parent as necessary. So in this case, if we wanted to add an element, say 8, we'd add it the very last element, and then we'd go and adjust our heap, moving things up as necessary. Now for the real fun, I need to actually implement these heapify methods. So heapify up is going to start with the very last element added, which is at size minus 1, and then it's going to walk up as long as there's a parent item, and as long as essentially I'm out of order. So as long as my parent item is bigger than me, then hey, things are out of order. So swap my value with my parent, and then walk upwards. So let's walk through this on the 8 that was inserted. So what we do here is we'll compare 8 to this 15. It's out of order, so we'll need to swap those values. So 15 goes down here and 8 goes up here. Or on the array, it'll look like this. Then we compare this 8 to the 10, and then that's still out of order. And so we'll go and move the 10 down and swap the 8 up there. And now we've returned to the heap properties. We have 8 at the top, 10 and 20 below it, then 17 and 15 below that. Heapify down is a little bit more complicated, but it's still quite manageable. First, we're gonna start off with our root element, which is at index 0. And then we're gonna say, well, as long as I have children, keep walking down and trying to fix up my heap. Now I only need to check if there's a left child, because if there's no left child, then there's certainly no right child. Then I'm gonna set this smaller child index equal to the smaller of the left and the right child. So I'm gonna stake a guess with set it equal to the left child. And then I'm gonna say, hey, if there's a right child and my right child is even smaller than my left child, smaller child index should equal my right child. Now what I'm gonna say, remember I'm looking downwards on the heap. So now what I'm gonna say is, hey, if items of index, if I'm smaller than the smaller of my two children, then everything's good and everything's back in order here and I can just exit. If that's not the case, then our heap is still out of order. And then I need to swap my value with my smaller child, and then move down to my smaller child. I'll just actually move this out here. All right, so that's the basics of how Heapify down works. Let's walk through this on an example. I'll make this example slightly larger. So if we do an extract min, such that 10 gets removed, then we remove 10, we replace it with 25, I'll do it on the array too so you can see what's going on there. Then we compare 25, the root, and replace it with the smaller of its left and right child. So we swap the 25 and the 15. So 25 comes down here, 15 comes up there, and we can do it down here too. So 15 goes here, 25 goes here. Then we compare 25 to 17. It's still out of order since 25 is bigger than 17. So we do
17 comes up here, we swap those, and 25 goes down here. So now we have a heap again that looks like 15, 17, 20, and 25. And as you can see, our min heap property has been restored. So now that you understand what a heap is and how it works, why don't you try out using a heap on a new problem? Good luck.